Thanks for joining us at Right On Replicas, where we bring you the best scale model kit reviews on the planet. This review covers the Round 2 re-release of the 1968 El Camino SS Derby Champions kit. This is Derby Champions 2, and it's a 125 scale AMT model kit number 1018. This kit is a skill level 2, as it requires glue and paint, and comes with the bonus soapbox derby car. It's seen many other box arts as a 68 Camino over the past few years, but the derby car hasn't been seen for quite a while. You get 100 parts molded in white, black, chrome, clear, and clear red with vinyl tires and metal axles. The tires are double-sided tampo printed units with the bonus as one side is red lines. The decals are all race style with no stock or interior decals included. And the instruction is typical old AMT format, because this is an old model design. As for the build, a detailed motor, a detailed and separate frame part for the chassis, with a standard old interior tub design, but individual parts for accent. The body is solid, solid and slides together well, and the finish is great. Overall, the dimensions are 8.5 inches long, 3 inches wide, and 2 inches high. Here are the decals for this kit. As you can see, they're very colorful and the registry is good. I strongly recommend using some decal setting solution to make it fit those contours, but as always, use the manufacturer's safety and use guidelines when using any of the products mentioned here in the review for your own protection. For most of the construction, I use Model Master liquid cement and sometimes a slow setting tube glue. But other adhesives are used too for strength, like super glue and white glue for clear parts. Mostly the paints are Tamiya acrylic bottle paints that are shot through an airbrush, or rattle can paints that can be used for things like primers. Here is my version of the open box review. I opened the box and these are all the parts. There you go, all in less than 15 seconds. The build starts with the motor, so grab these pieces and build the block, the heads, the oil pan, the intake, water pump, and paint that as a unit with Chevy orange and some aluminum for the transmission. The belts are rubber colored with steel and aluminum pulleys. The AC unit is steel, the alternator is aluminum, the fan and the power steering is black. Assemble and mount that unit, and the oil filter is blue. The starter is black with a gold solenoid and installed. And the carb is goldish tint, so install that. The exhaust manifolds are steel and installed, and then add the valve covers, paint the air filter white, and add that. The distributor is steel with a tan cap. You get a choice of two different rim sets here, so pick your rims out and install the hub and paint the rim back and the hub flat black. Then to give the tires a road look, just press and roll the tread on a sheet of fine sandpaper. Then install the front rim to the inside of your tire, depending on which way you want to display it, and add the rim back to the other side. Now, I use the American Racing rims, and so to give the rims a different look, I painted the spokes a steel color. Now get out these parts for the interior and assemble the seats, then paint the floor flat black. The console seats, rear trim, and door panels are semi-gloss black. Then highlight the trim on the doors with a silver Sharpie. Install the seats, the console, door panels, and the rear trim. Then add the shifter to the console. Now round up the parts for the dash and the wheel. And they're semi-gloss. So highlight the dash with a silver pen. And the instruments are with a white paint or pen with some red needles. Then install the wheel and the dash into the interior on the slots provided. Now we'll assemble the bed for the body. So assemble the bed and paint the bed a body color, then clear coat the inside of the bed. And the fuel tank is steel colored with a flat black frame. We'll assemble the frame next. So paint the frame black, and the exhaust is steel colored with aluminum mufflers. The firewall is body color on the outside and flat black on the inside. The steering link is steel, and install the exhaust and firewall with the steering link. Then add the interior and bed to the frame. Get the suspension parts out and paint those black for the rear suspension. The shocks are red, assemble the differential and add the lower links and springs as you install the suspension into place. Add the sway bar and the upper links to the axle and add the shocks. Gather the pieces for the front suspension and paint those black. Install the springs and the spindles and add the lower suspension, then install the upper A-arms. The tires are non-directional, so you can install them anywhere, so place those on the spindles or the axle points on the model. Paint the drive shaft steel colored, and after that's dried, install the engine mount and the drive shaft simultaneously to the pumpkin. Now you have a rolling chassis to build the rest of your model kit on. Now we'll start the body prep, so take the hood and the body and wet sand them with a fine grit sandpaper to remove any blemishes. Look for any mold lines, sink marks, etc. And it's known for having sink marks in the roof and other blemishes. But mine was not too bad, so I saw no need to really fix anything beyond normal sanding. I think they've done a good job of recreating this kit. Prime the whole body with a good quality product, which is compatible with your finish colors. Now, if you see any blemishes after that, fix them and sand them again. And as you can see, my roof was in pretty good condition right out of the box. This kit comes with a molded-in vinyl roof. So I'm going to paint mine black, and first I did that by taping it off after I painted it. Now spray the body your choice of color coats and do any other paint work that you need to do. I used a metallic blue, just slightly darker than factory, on my car. And instead of foiling this one, I used a Sharpie and a pen to do all the chrome trim because I wanted a dull chrome look. Now on to the windows, and to give my glass a thin, crisp look, I dip it into some Pledge floor polish and then let it wick off and dry. It's amazing the difference. Use some Tester's clear part cement for windows or some white glue to install the windows into the interior cab. Install the mirror onto the window. Now we can decal the body, but some of the SS stripes decals are pretty large, so I strongly suggest you use some of the setting solutions that are available to and put those into place, along with a lot of warm water to make sure that you can slide them into position. Now you can apply a clear coat to seal those decals onto the body. Now we'll mate the body to the chassis, and it's a very tight fit, so you'll just need to pull the sides out carefully, then wedge the interior and bed into the body. Then be careful with the motor, and it'll all fit together tightly, so don't knock the motor loose or pieces there. Once it's lined up, it slides right up and into the frame and sits in the body. Now we'll gather these parts to complete the engine bay under the hood, paint the battery, radiator, and the booster black, and the hoses are rubber color. The AC lines are aluminum, and the master cylinder is steel with gold top plate. The water bottle is white, and the radiator is installed from the front. Add the battery, the water bottle, the AC lines, and the heater lines, and the radiator lines, and brake booster and master cylinder to the engine bay. I wanted to personalize my model, so I printed out my logo to look like a license plate on some plain white paper with an inkjet printer, and then I cut it out and taped over it with some cellophane that's got a gloss to it to make it look like a rear license plate. Later on, I'll glue that to the bumper and license plate holder with some white glue. Now grab that grill and using a 50-50 wash of flat black with thinner, highlight the grill and then add the headlights and use some white glue or clear part cement. Add the license tag and install the grill into the car. Then add the side mirrors. The marker lights then are painted with some translucent yellow. Install the brake lights using these pieces and add the license to the bumper in the rear. Now, at this point, your car is finished and you can move to build the derby car. There's just a few pieces to the derby car, as you can see. So go ahead and assemble the car and then paint it your choice of colors. Now, the wheels can be painted an alternate color or, you know, or a contrast or the same, but the tires are rubber colored. Now add the decals of your choice. And there's also a stand for the car to sit on. Well, I painted it metallic black, and did the inside of the Chevy bow tie with some bare metal foil. This kit comes with some extra goodies, including a fold-up, pop-up display stand for you to put the model on to display with pride. You'll have only a few parts left over, the extra rims and unused decals. Well, there you have it. Round 2 has brought back a great kit of the 68 El Camino SS. And this time they paired it up with a really nifty looking derby race car. It builds up into a nicely detailed car with a vinyl roof. The motor only needs some aftermarket wires to make it look good. The chassis is well detailed and defined, and it's a multiple part unit, more like a real car. The interior is multiple parts and easy to detail. Some decals would be a benefit there, but you'll have to supply those yourself from extra kits. The body's still not perfect. It has a few blemishes and mold lines, but you never find one of those. For an AMT kit, this is one of the better ones, and it's great to have it back. The little derby car was a treat. Now overall, the fit and finish was excellent, and I really had no issues with construction. The car fell together, and it looks great on the shelf. I'm sure you'll have fun building yours. We hope you liked this premium quality step-by-step review, and so that you don't miss any more, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. But you can find us on Facebook and also at our website, www.rightonreplicas.com. Thanks!